Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I just wanna be happy, happy tonight. Today I am going to be doing my March monthly favourites. Yes. I don't know when this video is going up, so it might not even be March anymore. But it's definitely March while I'm filming, so there's that. But yeah, let's just jump right into it. I'm going to start with the makeup category, so let's just start there. So the first thing on the list is the Mario Badescu skincare spray thingy-majiggy. This is nearly empty, as you can see. And I also have gone through an entire bottle already. There's a little bit down the bottom. You know what? You know what would make my life so much easier? Instead of trying to use that tiny bit and never being able to get any of it, let's just tip it into this bottle. There we go. Life hacks. Definitely didn't go through this in March, don't worry. But it's remained a favourite, let's just put it that way. The second item is the Maybelline Age Rewind Concealer. I always find myself going back to this concealer. I've tried many others and this one's just so good. I don't know what it is. It's the formula, actually, I don't know what it is. But yeah, it's really good and I always go back to it. The third thing I will be talking about is the highlighter that I got off Wish early last year at some point. It's what I got on today. As you can see, it's blinding. It's blinding, okay? And it's such a good highlighter, and I just love it, and it'll forever live in my heart, so. The fourth item I'll be talking about is the Maybelline, the Colossal Big Shot Volume Express Mascara. This is so good. I love this mascara so much, and yeah, that's basically all I have to say about that. I have lost track of numbers, so I'm just gonna say, the next thing I'll be talking about is the Watermelon Carmex Moisturizing Lip Balm. This stuff, I got it on now. This stuff is just so good. Like, it tingles your lips. I haven't read into it or if there's a reasoning for that. I believe it's meant to be lip plumping if it tingles, but don't think it lip plumps. I don't think it plumps my lips, but it just really good lip balm, like so moisturizing. Next item is the Jaclyn Hill Morphe palette. This has been a favorite ever since I got it, but I have been using it a lot this month, just like any other month. Yeah, I just really love this one. So yeah, haven't gotten a chance to get the James Charles one yet. So when I get that one, that'll probably be the new favorite. That sounds mean. That'll probably be one of the new favorites. But yeah, I definitely love this one. It's really good and it's beautiful. The next item is more a tool, and it's the Y6. Yeah, this is really good. I use this to apply my foundation and concealer and sometimes powder if I can't be bothered to get this one out. But yeah, along with that, another tool is Naya. Are you done? Come here. Come here. Okay, she's done. No, she's not. Okay, if I just ignore her. Okay, she's cleaning herself. The next tool is the Morphe R36. Yes, I read that right. And that's the brush I use for highlighter. And yeah, I love this brush and I use it like every day. That's bad. Anyways, The next category I'll be talking about is like scents, fragrances, I guess. So yeah, let's get into that. Don't have the lid on because low-key don't know where it is, but my favourite perfume is definitely the Katy Perry Meow. Normally has a little cat head sitting on top of it. Naya, speaking of cats. Yes, kitty. She's so talkative today. Really? Timing? I'm trying to film a video. She is the most attention-seeking cat I've ever met in my life. If you're not giving her attention, then you're completely betraying her in her eyes. And it's really inconvenient when I'm trying to film a video. Come over here then, Jesus Christ. The next one is a little concentrated fragrance in a little bottle. I got this from Shop Miss A, and it's the True Love type. This smells so good, like so good. So would definitely recommend this. If it's a dollar, like, you can't go wrong. It smells so good, and it's like strong enough where you don't need much. Like, I just put some on my wrist and it's like overpowering, like at least a meter circumference. Is that the right word? We're gonna go with it. If it's not, I'm sorry, I'm not smart. The next item is the Rexona Sexy Bouquet deodorant. I always go back to this because it smells so good. It's definitely not the best. Like, it leaves like white under your armpits and stuff like that, but I just can't get past the smell. It just smells, that was so rude. It just smells so good, and I just can't seem to get past that. That one factor is what keeps me going back. Otherwise, probably, you know, would use something that doesn't leave like white marks. But it's the smell. It's the smell. So it's definitely been a monthly favorite because it's nearly empty. Another perfume that has been my favorite is the Beyonce Hey Wolf Sugar. No, that just tells me that it's flammable. I know this. Oh, I don't know what it is. I threw out the box. Why did I do that? I literally threw it out the other day. Listen, I'll put a photo up here of what it is and it'll have the name and everything. But yeah, this is the 100ml Beyonce something heat. Because I'm pretty sure the purple one, which I've got over there, is Midnight Heat. They might not... What? They might all be Midnight Heat, and this just might be... I don't know. I'll have to look it up. But that's frustrating that literally the other day I threw out the box. That doesn't mean I just got it the other day and it's down to here. I mean, I found the box the other day and I was like, oh, don't need that. Wow. Turns out I did need that. The irony in that sentence. Foreshadowing? Oh my god, yes. Another scented item is the I got this from Kmart. It was only a few dollars, and it's the salted caramel scented candle from Anko, and it's like this light pink color. On camera, definitely doesn't look pink, definitely looks like nude, but in person it's like a nudey pink. Yes, Naya, she's being so rude. So yeah, this, it smells like... if you've had those... Okay, again, another thing where I'm going to have to insert a picture. Wow, editing me is not impressed. Neither is Naya. You're so high maintenance. I mean, same, but... honestly. Yeah, I guess that's the best way to describe it. It's like close... I mean, it's meant to smell like salted caramel. Salted caramel. It smells like strawberry, those strawberry lollies. Like the strawberry and cream lollies. Strawberry and cream lollies. That's what it smells like to me. Is when you have a jar of strawberry and creams and then you open up the jar and it's just... That's what this smells like. So, yeah. I love you. You're doing my head in. You're doing my head in. Yeah, the next category is going to be like food, edible items. So yeah, let me go get them. Okay, so I got three things. The first thing, and anybody who knows me will know this. This is like so basic, but the 90 cent lemon soft drinks from Coles are my actual guilty pleasure. That's just gonna sit there in the corner so you can just be reminded of how much an angel that drink is. Not just like a monthly flavor. A monthly favorite. More like a lifetime favorite. Same goes for the next two items. So. Mars bar. As you can see, already dug in. And the last item for edibles is honey soy chicken chips. These are so good. Oh, you probably can't hear me because they're so loud. These are so good. I love these chips. Okay, here's a fun little story. Shout out to Steph, Caitlin, Indigo, and Tate. I reckon Tate would obviously know because he would go order it from the canteen for me sometimes. But before our canteen in high school changed, so probably when I was in year 11, I'd say, yeah, definitely the start of year 11, my order for $5 at the canteen for lunch was not healthy, put it that way, was always a packet of honey soy chicken chips, a strawberry milk, and two caramello koalas. That was my $5 lunch. All the time. If Steph's watching this and she knows, like, she knows that so well, like, she would definitely be able to vouch for me and be like, yep, that's true. But then they stopped selling caramello koalas and my heart hurt a little bit. So that was rude. And they also changed the prices and upped the prices, which was also very rude. So then my order for $5 turned into honey soy chicken chips and a strawberry milk. No more caramello koalas, and that was $5 still. So they upped the prices. Caramel koalas were 50 cents, so I could get two for a dollar. The strawberry milk was $2 and the chips were $2. And then it turned out the chips were $3 and then the milk was $2 still. My heart definitely hurt the day they stopped selling caramel koalas. But I made it through because I still had my other two tried and trues. So did that rhyme? I don't know. That's a fun little side story there. If I had a bottle here, it would definitely be strawberry milk. And yeah, my replacement of caramel koalas. Next category is accessories. So thank you, Nan, for my silver bangle. Wear that all the time. Oops. Tate for my promise ring. My auntie for my signet ring. And then also my auntie for this ring, which I don't think she realised, but I definitely found it when she was living at our house a few years ago and took it. Thank you. These little star earrings that my boyfriend's mum got me for my birthday? No, for Christmas. It was definitely for one of them. No, it was for Christmas. Okay, I remember now because I was like trying to remember, because we've been together for 2 years, so I'm trying to remember the different occasions and what I got for which one. It's definitely a Christmas present. So yeah, that was my accessories. The next category is hair. So yeah. Okay, because that's wet from the shower. I'm so smart. Because I've got hair that really... Because I've got blonde in my hair that's been bleached. Yeah, I need to maintain the blonde. So I've got this Matrix Total Results So Silver shampoo to neutralize yellow. Okay, cool. So we got that. This was not cheap. This was like freaking $30 for this little bottle. But it does the job. Definitely does the job. running out, that's terrifying. I definitely do not want to spend $30 again, but it's fine. It is what it is. So yeah, I got this one. And then I got another shampoo that I like as well, mainly for the smell. But we don't talk about that. This one, it's the Touch of Silver for Blonde, Platinum or White Hair Color Care Shampoo Cleanse and Care from Professional Hair Care. Okay. It looks like this and it smells so good. It just smells like really sweet and like lollies. So my hair smells like lollies, basically. not with this stuff though. This stuff, it doesn't smell bad. Oh. You can't take the lid off. That's interesting. Okay. Ooh. Yeah, it doesn't smell bad. It just, I don't know. It smells a bit chemically in a way. But yeah, this smells like lollies. So we love that. And I got the matching shampoo. This is shampoo. I got the matching conditioner. This one, as you can see, it's a bit worse for wear. It's empty. So, got the new one, which is, again, you can tell, still worse for wear because I go through these so quickly because I love conditioner, unlike my boyfriend. For general like care when I'm like styling or whatever, I really like the Garnier Fructus. Sounds like I'm swearing. I don't like that. Miraculous Oil. Looks like that. This smells so good as well. I wouldn't know how to describe that smell though. Not that I'm good at describing smells anyway. And then same kind of vibe because it is also a Garnier Fructus? I don't know. Sleek and Shine Anti-Frizz Serum. And this guy smells so good. Oh my god. It smells like apples. Yeah, I don't think it has a scent on there, but it smells like apples. Okay, it smells like apples. And then we've also got the Palmolive Detangling Spray. This is literally for kids, I'm pretty sure. But I got some pretty knotty hair, so I need it. And it smells good. Everything smells good. It smells good to me. I feel like the vibe I'm giving off right now is like, if it smells good, I'll buy it. But like, that's not always the case. It just happens to be a case with a lot of my monthly favorites. And a lot of the things in my life, but we're not gonna talk about it. So yeah, that's everything for hair care. Let me put these back. The next category is skincare. Oh, it is the skincare drawer. That was so convenient. That wasn't. Everything's falling. This is the Garnier Skin Active Micellar Cleansing Water. This is getting on the verge of being empty. And yeah, definitely. Why? Why am I so uncoordinated? Definitely on the verge of finishing this, and I definitely approve and would recommend this 1000%. The next three items I'm going to be talking about is like skincare, but it comes like they're together. Does that make sense? Clean and Clear. This is the Essentials Self-Foaming Facial Wash. Oh, the hiccups, I'm so sorry. So yeah, there's this. I'm nearly empty. And then you use the Clean and Clear Essentials Oil Control Toner. This, I had to buy a new one. I don't know where the old one is. It should nearly be empty though. But I love this stuff so much that I just bought a new one even though I wasn't completely out of the other one. But then I lost it anyways. So why? Like, can we just take a moment to question why I'm so clumsy and uncoordinated? Unbelievable. Anyways, so I had to start using this one anyway. The Clean and Clear Essentials Moisturizer. Now, whilst this is a monthly favorite because I use it, I'm not impressed because I had one of these already and I loved it so much. Like, I loved the consistency and the smell. Here we go again with me and my scented things. But yeah, it smelled like watermelons. and it made it very pleasant to put on my face. And this one, look, it literally says improved formula. I don't know if you can see that, but this one, the formula, I don't think is as good. I don't think it's as moisturizing as the old one, and it doesn't smell like watermelon. It smells like crap. Like, I don't like the smell of this at all. It smells like chemicals. And yeah, so I'm quite mad at them for that. They really messed up. Unbelievable. Yeah, that's all I have for, what did I name the category? Like, skincare? Skincare. I think that's what I called it. The next category is like body care. Let's go with that. It's from Cotton On, so yeah. It was a dollar at Cotton On when I was in Queensland with my boyfriend. We went to the outlet shopping center in Queensland, and this was a dollar, and I wish I had bought in five. Borton? I'm not only clumsy physically, I'm clumsy mentally. But I wish I had bought five of them, because they just smell so good. And yeah, I'm like halfway through this one, and I don't know, I would definitely recommend it, it smells so good. But then, I mean, I guess it's a very selective thing, because it kind of smells like red medicine. If you're Australian, you know what I'm talking about when you think of like red medicine as a kid having to take that. It smells like that a bit. Some people will just argue that it completely smells like that, but I can smell the berry in it. So yeah, I like the smell of it until I kind of get the waft of red medicine, and then I'm like, mm. And then the last item I have for body care would be, I'll put a picture up here, my Vaseline moisturizer in like aloe vera or whatever it is, the green one. That smells really good. Oh my god, again. Gonna have to put a counter up. But yeah, that smells really good, and I would go get it and show it to you, but my brother has it at the moment, so I can't. But just know that that's in there. Like, it's a monthly favorite. And yeah, I believe that that's all for this video. I hope I haven't missed any categories that I'm not thinking about right now. I can't remember. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Give it a big thumbs up and subscribe and follow my social medias, and yeah, I'll see you guys. Bye guys. I'm so weird. Turn off.